Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Good timing. Old Faithful's going off. And it's currently 4:30 p.m. Yeah, that's quite a show. It was showing a little discolorization there earlier, a few minutes ago. Kind of dirty before it went off. USGS is reporting only 9 earthquakes within the last 24 hours. And only 2 for today. I got a message from one of my followers who lives there and said, I believe it was about 6 o'clock last night, she felt an earthquake. So we'll see if I can find that. More recently, about 45 minutes ago, there was an earthquake, almost a magnitude 3. It was a 2.99. And they haven't reported it. They haven't reported anything since this 0.5. At 9:10 this morning. They got 2 for today, a 0.5 and a 0.6, and then yesterday a 1.1, a 1.9, a 0.9, a 1.3, 0.2, 0.0, and a 0.2. This here is a stream view. This is live. This earthquake, which you can see on all 4 monitors, came in at about 3:10 p.m. So they are an hour behind me, so this was actually 8:10 a.m. That's the last earthquake they reported. So this earthquake at 2:10 their time, there at Yellowstone, comes in as a magnitude 2.99. Yeah, they were worried about magnitude 2s. Now we're getting 3s, and it's like business as usual. You ever have the feeling where there's just not enough hours in a day? Well, that's me today. Well, a lot of days, actually. Had to get the landlord over to fix my sink, which wasn't draining. I want to can some pressure can some hot dogs, and I'll probably do that. And I got a message from this woman saying somewhere around 6 o'clock, and she lives there at Yellowstone, she felt an earthquake. So this one was at 6:33 p.m. And if you're watching this video, this is the earthquake probably that you felt. Depending on what part of the park you live in, how well you would have felt it. This is a monitor for the Maple Creek area. And here we have the monitor for the borehole. Remember, this is a very deep well. Same earthquake. And it doesn't show up too well. It shows up better on the other monitor. Looks like a lot of hot gases came up. And this is for Maple Creek. And how well did you feel it there? I want to extract that and see what we got. Sharp points. Yeah, this was tectonic in nature. There is some little bit rounded ones, so it did stir up the caldera a little bit. Between 5 and 10 hertz. It was probably in the upper magma chamber. And it was a small earthquake. It comes in as a magnitude 1.76. There was others that were larger. Did you feel those also? Okay, there's the one that we started out with. And then we got another one here at 4:03 Universal. That would have been at 10:03 Mountain Time. This one has rounded tops, so that would be volcanic in nature. And the hertz is between 1 and, oh, it goes almost all the way up to 15 hertz. Yeah, again, this is in the upper magma chamber. See, these earthquakes are increasing in size. This is a magnitude 2.84. Did you feel that one? All right, 9:35 p.m. Your time there, mountain time. That one was a magnitude 2.04. If you felt that other one, which was so much smaller, you had to have felt these. And let's go to its signature. Yeah, tectonic and volcanic. Let's go back to the spectrogram. Okay. That one too. Yeah, see, it goes almost all the way up to 15 hertz. See the line of melt too? The next one, 409 universal. That would have been 10:09 p.m. Yeah, after this one here. Okay. 10:09 p.m. last night. That would have been a magnitude 2.07. All right, so let's go to the more recent ones. We got one. I'll do that one because that one's a little bit bigger than that one. At 14:10, that is the one of the two that USGS is reporting. They're saying it's a 0.5. I really gave them the benefit of the doubt. Shortened up the seismic signature. It's actually a magnitude 1.54. So they're saying it's a magnitude 0.5. Yeah, let's take off the 1 and we'll just call it a 5 when it's actually a 1.54. All right, the next one marked in red at 14, almost 36 universal, 8:36 their time. That comes in as a magnitude 1.27. And let's make that bigger. Oh, this is volcanic. Yep. Okay, let's go back to, I have to make that smaller. Right there. Okay. Yeah, between, maybe 3 and slightly above 10 hertz. Now, this monitor here is the borehole. And this is the other one that they reported. It's not in red. At 6:21 universal. They're saying is a 0.6. Can you see it there in light blue? Again, this is the Madison River area, and I'll bring it back out for you. Oh, I went too far. Okay. And I think you can see where I shortened up. Maybe I'll make it a little bit shorter, the seismic signature for this one. Let's go to the spectrogram. Okay, and back to the signature. Now this comes in as a magnitude 1.36. And for those of you who get the larger screens, it's MD 1.36. not a 0.6. Nope. And let's go to the, yeah, just a bunch of heated water. You know, they reported this one. And for the borehole, we got, let's see, 14:10. I think I did that one. What's this one here? 3:50. Okay, they did not report that one. And that's another very small earthquake. Let's see. We'll go there and we'll go. I'm going to shorten it farther than I want to. That's a magnitude 1.32. Let me bring it down. I should have extended it out a little bit farther. 1.32. This is when I pulled the files, and you can see here we got tectonic tremors going on. I wanted to show you too, because this is the borehole where we have the blobs of magma coming in because of the slow-moving tremors. These are slow-moving tremors where they don't have a definite popping of the rock. It just continues to rattle. Yeah, you can see it's shaking up. The caldera is shaking up. All right, Soda Butte. Yeah, this is, I just wanted to take a look what it was doing during that time. And, oh my God, oh, there is the screaming. 17:15 universal. So that would have been 11:15 p.m. Oh, when I come over a little farther, I'll show you. It gets even hotter. Let me pull this over. See that? How red it got? Let's go over a little bit farther. See what else we have through here. All right, let's go to this one. Okay. Slow moving tremor. Oops, I went off the line. Sorry about that. Oh, there's more screaming. Let me bring it over. More screaming. 1730. That would have been 1130 last night. See that? And yeah, for some reason the data didn't download here. Let's take a look what it was doing when I pulled the files. Oh, okay. 2111. 3:11 p.m. this afternoon, and we'll bring it over and see if we can see anything else that was going on there at Soda Butte. Now remember, this is up there by the northeast of the park. Went off the line. All right, so we're going to go there using Google Earth so you'll know where it's at. Here we go. Zooming in. Right there. Okay, that's Soda Butte. Like I said, this is the northeastern part of the park. And I've talked before about how actually the magma for the caldera, which is drawn out in red, has extended more so northeast. And we know that from my past reports where I did, where they had that 4.2. And that was on the 11th of May. Yeah, Soda Butte right there. All right, so let's pull it over a little bit farther and see what else we got. Oh, more screaming right there. 2103. 3:03 p.m. local time. Let's take a look at Little West Thumb. Yeah, I didn't. That was me. Yeah, I got distracted with my plumbing and waiting on the landlord to show up. And then the grandkids showing up after school. I want to see what it's showing here. Okay, so it was screaming. Yeah, it's not screaming there at that time. And let's go there. Just kind of jump around and look. There's that one earthquake that I reported. Let's jump over here. See what we got. It looks like there at West Thumb, the activity has settled down a little bit. We still have the line of melt. But with me jumping around and looking at this different activity, I don't see any screaming, not to say that there isn't. And it would just take me forever to go line by line looking for the stuff. Let me bring it down a little bit farther. For when I pulled the files again. Oops. Alright, let's pull it down. Yeah, it's settled down, which is a good sign. Keep those prayers coming in. We got a series of small quakes there. Yeah, popping of the rock. It didn't scream, but we do have popping of the rock at 1832, which would have been 1232. This afternoon. And that looks like it happened after we had this tectonic movement here prior to that. That's over here on this, on the right. Yeah, we had some tectonic movement that probably just stirred up the caldera. Yeah. And increased the pressure where then we had the popping of the ground. So for those of you that live there, did you feel any of those earthquakes? That's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you.